My name is Michael Jordan. I play professional basketball for the Chicago Bulls.
32 seconds to go. A one-point lead for Georgetown. Jordy to block. The time, 18. Shot, Jordan! Michael Jordan!
If I had to trace my evolution, the Michael Jordan evolution, it always had to start back in college. Hitting a shot against Georgetown in 1982 when I really didn't know exactly what I was doing.
North Carolina has won the 1982 NCAA championship.
It awakened a person inside of me to excel, to compete, to excel, to be one of the best or be the best. That drove me. And I guess with that shot, it kind of ignited a fire inside of me that nothing was going
to
stop me.
About to meet somebody every kid on every playground in America is talking about.
Jordan, the length of the floor, let's watch.
That he is one of the greatest players ever is indisputable.
Here's a kaboom. Michael Air Jordan.
Initially, it was great. I mean, who wouldn't want to be in the commercials or want to see your posters or your billboards all over the place? You know, I'm just a country boy from North Carolina, and to be on television to do these things were great.
Look at the hang time. Look at the flying motion.
Nobody in the world can cover my main man, Michael Jordan. Nobody.
Michael Jordan!
Michael Jordan! Stop!
What'd you expect? You're my friend? It's just one of those freak situations, I guess. It has a lot to do with timing and a lot to do with personality.
Still time to grab a burger?
I don't know. You know, and I don't know what continues. Keep it going.
The inbounds pass comes into Jordan. Here's Michael at the foul line. A shot on Elo. Good! The Bulls win! They win!
That was get the ball, Michael. Everybody get the ball out of the way. Close the basket.
As long as we're on this earth, I think everybody wants to be known as a winner. And the only way you can be remembered on this earth is to win.
You ever see Michael Jordan?
Just in those commercials.
Think mom would like me in these? Maybe.
Maybe you'll see him do one of those 360 dunks.
Neal, he kept it in bounds. Here it is again.
Oh! There's a lot of criticism. Oh, Jordan can't do all that scoring, and yet they still win. And that was enough to get me to this point where, you know, I had to take this team or be a leader to this team to get to a championship.
Jordan trying to shake off Starks. Oh, what a move by Jordan!
This is what you live for, to play Michael Jordan in the finals.
You better eat your Wheaties.
3-on-2 for the Bulls. Michael on the drive, in for the right, put it in. Oh, a spectacular move by Michael Jordan.
The Bulls blowing the Lakers out. And the Chicago Bulls have won their first ever NBA championship.
We're going to Disney.
I was going to basically get to this point where I wanted to be, and it took a while, but, well, a while is 8 years, but I got to this point, and now it's a matter of staying on top, and that's what I have to do.
After 25 years, the great basketball fans of Chicago have been rewarded by a great basketball team, the 1991 NBA World Champion Chicago Bulls.
As a member of this team and an organization and the city of Chicago for 7 years, it brings me great joy to say we are the world champions. Thank you. Like the guy on King of the Hill situation. Once you're on top of the hill, you want to defend it. We played that season, we played last season as though no matter what we encounter, we're still going to finish the season on top.
To Michael! Yeah! And a
start the season.
As I was growing up, when we was playing against the Celtics would come in and, you know, they knew they was going to beat us no matter how we start the game. They just knew we were going to fold and they were going to come back and beat us. You know, Kevin McHale would, you know, would talk more trash than anybody you've ever seen, and Bird as well. But they knew they were going to win. And I think we had that same attitude.
A running conversation with Stacey Ogman hits for
the... When you trash talk, yeah, that's a game. It's a game of psyche now.
They're talking to Michael right now. You love to see it.
He hit the shot on you, and then he tells you about it. Jordan and Starks chatting with each other.
They try to take it as a one-on-one competition to me, which totally takes away from their team concept.
The one thing when you play against Michael Jordan, you not only have to stand up to him physically, you have to stand up to him mentally because he will torment you.
I know how to play the game. I don't think they know how to play the game when I'm talking to him.
He looks for something to get him in this kind of frame of mind. Just like that, in your face. See, he looks for an edge. He wants Starks to come back at him.
No matter what trash you talk, we're going to talk the most trash and we're going to back it up.
Let's watch Jordan. I think he's talking to Mutombo.
I told him I was going to shoot this with my eyes closed. Nah, you won't do it, you won't do it. But he never known. I've done this before. As you know, I closed my eyes and shot it and made it. And I told him, welcome to the NBA. And moved on.
At this point, it has been strictly a celebration of the Chicago Bulls.
It shocked me. I mean, I thought it was a joke. I thought he was just kidding around. He was just playing with me. And I said, you serious? He said, yep. Irvin's going to retire today. I said, yeah, you're kidding. And Irvin's going to retire for what?
Because of the HIV virus that I have attained, I will have to retire from the Lakers today.
Yo, he and I was just establishing a great relationship after the first three, four rocky years.
Stay healthy. Have a good Stay healthy.
I just want to say that I'm going to miss playing.
I didn't really get the opportunity to play basketball against him like I wanted to because he was my driving force. You know, Magic Johnson was here, he and Larry Bird was here. I was still here. And for me to get here, I had to beat these guys. And I felt I was being cheated, that, you know, he was getting away from the game when I needed him the most.
I made sure that I called Larry, Michael, Isaiah, the guys who I'm close with.
You know, I don't know what to say, you know, but I'm with you, I love you, I want you to want what's best for you, and I'm willing to follow your footsteps. What should I do? Tell me.
Doesn't matter who you are or what you do, age is everybody's problem. Magic has given all of us a great responsibility. Let's not let him down. Get the facts.
Now that Magic's retired, you're kind of the ambassador of the NBA now. Is there a lot of pressure on you these days?
You start to think about different things that could happen to you that, hey, you may have to call a press conference and, you know, at some point in time and explain yourself.
Back here at home, everybody's buzzing about the soon-to-be-released book on the Bulls, The Jordan Rule.
The book, Jordan Rules, will be released soon, and some of its passages have already created a stir.
A forthcoming book on the championship season of last year portrays a selfish Jordan who told his teammates not to pass the ball into center Bill Cartwright late in the game.
I think everybody saw what was in the paper today. But somebody said, never believe what you read in the papers.
And back to the legends, Jordan was kind of a tough guy with some of his teammates.
Jordan denies the book's accounts.
If I'm going to be knocked off this pedestal, I'm going to make sure I do something to be knocked off. I'm not going to let someone else knock me off for no apparent reason or, you know, comments that I didn't say.
Players giving out sensitive information to the press is one surefire way to cause a division within the team. It figures to be a bumpy ride as the Bulls try to defend their NBA championship.
We never talked about it. You know, we knew the truth of this team and what relationships we had on this team. No matter what the book illustrated, if anything, it brought us closer together. To keep what happens between these 12 players or 15 people within us instead of letting people get inside that circle. So it bonded us, and we focused more on playing basketball.
What time is it? Game time!
Michael, tongue is out, spin move. Nice pass inside. Michael.
Michael, cross court, Purdue! Michael and a bullet pass! Here come the Bulls again. Michael, bounce pass!
Yes, he dropped it back. He dropped it back to Scotty. That's the nail, baby. That's the nail.
Michael, you know, he really took matters in his own hands out there at the stretch of the game.
And Murkowski tosses the inbound pass, and he's there with a steal. On the run, got Paxson, Pippen, Paxson, got it! Bulls are going to get the win, and the fans love it.
Whenever it's time for Michael to take over a game, you know, he takes it over.
Michael, high for the rebound, can he save it? He does! And he's all right! Isaiah splits the defense, but Michael was there, one-on-one with Orr. Michael, got it!
What really happened with this team was we accepted a challenge. And I think that was a part of the maturity of this team. But for Michael Jordan, the complexity of my life has changed. I mean, I worked for so many years to get to a point where I like to think that I'm one of the best. And now everything, every move, every shot, everything is in the spotlight. I mean, you're a target now. I'm a target now.
We've all heard about the rewards of being you. How hard is it to be you?
Into Michael, running one hand. Oh, yes!
You were a zone, Michael, and were you just really feeling it?
And you thought nice, Mike, about to take over.
Watch Michael, because he wants it.
Michael,
what would you like to do? Jordan, a lot of fakes and the scoop shot for two.
Oh, what a play. Turn toward me a little bit more, just like that. Thank you. Put the ball under your right foot, please.
Once again, he's the man, Michael Jordan, today named Sports Illustrated's Man of the Year. And SI celebrated their selection with a special hologram cover. You can have Michael's head rotating on your coffee table. It's amazing.
Anytime people talk about you in a positive way, it's great to hear those comments. You know, my first 5-6 years, I really enjoyed it. It was something to be happy about. But I'm at a stage in my career, in my life, that I wouldn't mind if people pass me by and don't say a word. That wouldn't bother me one bit.
The Chicago Bulls win their 13th game in a row.
That put Chicago at 36-5, the best first-half record in NBA history.
The red-hot Chicago Bulls on pace to become the winningest team in NBA history.
And now the focus for the regular season clearly becomes beating the Lakers' 20-year-old record of 69 wins in a season.
We basically just been saying, hey, let's collect the wins, let's keep it going. And that's how we're going to do from here on in. You know, if we get 70 wins this way, great, you guys can leave us alone for till next year. And the media was making such a big hype out of it that it was tough to do, tough to think about anything but 70 games.
The Bulls are now ready to embark on their last long road trip of the season. When the Bulls return, we'll have a pretty good idea if the Bulls have a legitimate shot at the Lakers' record for victories in one season.
And the Spurs have ended the Chicago winning streak,
and the Rockets have won the game. Chicago loses its second straight game in Texas.
Right now, Chicago is in disarray.
The Bulls' hope for winning 70 are starting to slip away.
The Chicago Bulls locking up in a game to remember with the Utah Jazz. Tight one all the way.
Look, there's Jordan, they got him. He'll raise, he's alone. He misses. They go to overtime.
Through one overtime, then two.
6-5-4, Jordan. 2 seconds, Jordan. We go to overtime, our third overtime.
And again, Michael Jordan comes up short.
And into a third.
Third midcourt, 3 seconds. Jeff challenges Michael Jordan. Foul Jordan. Foul Michael Jordan.
I lost it. I totally lost it.
Michael Jordan. Where's the team? Michael. He's got it. He's out of here. Jordan's out of here. That's going out of the game. Michael Jordan is gone.
I was in a rage. You should have saw me in the locker room. I kicked chairs in. I broke the blackboard. I mean, this is the first time that I've ever lost it in a competition.
Well, it seems Michael Jordan isn't perfect after all. The NBA's marquee name was suspended for tonight's game and fined $5,000 by the league. Jordan didn't appeal the penalties and left saying he'll see you in Orlando on All-Star Weekend.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 42nd annual NBA All-Star Game.
has been plenty of magic here in Orlando. Magic Johnson, that is. 3 months ago, he announced his retirement from the NBA, but he was voted by the fans as one of the starting guards for the Western Conference Stars.
I respect him so much, and I'm happy to get the opportunity to spend time with him again. And I felt that this was his opportunity to come back and shine. I just want to be behind the scenes and let him stand forward, let him stand in front of the camera.
Oh, now it's Jordan against Magic. The crowd on its feet.
I just wanted him to get the enjoyment of being back and playing against, amongst the guys.
Michael said, you're not getting it.
Yes, he is.
But when you're great, you deliver on cue. Three straight trays for Johnson at the end of the game. Three-pointer. Yes! Oh, my! Ladies and gentlemen, you just can't orchestrate it better than that.
It was great timing. You know, it's like, God, okay, you had enough beating. Now here goes something positive for you to follow. And then, as you know, it carried me for a while.
Comes Jordan. Behind the ball. What a play!
After the All-Star break, it was pretty obvious that we weren't going to win 70 games. And for the team, things pretty much got back to normal.
The Bulls are back to their winning ways.
But for me, it wasn't going to be that easy.
Well, it appears to err is human, even when that human in question is Michael Jordan. The NBA has investigated reports concerning Jordan's alleged gambling on golf.
No one likes to be susceptible to that circumstance, to where people out of the blue give criticism towards you and say, look at him, look at this guy. We thought he was perfect, and yet, you know, look at him, he's made a mistake. No one's perfect, even Michael Jordan, you or anybody else. I think that the lesson that comes from this is that, you know, when you make a mistake, you gotta stand up and accept it, and you'll move on. That was one of the things that happened to me through a very trying year of my career. But as I said, with any adversity, if I can accept, you know, good things that happen to me, I can certainly deal with the bad and move straight forward.
The conclusion of that investigation, the league will take no disciplinary action against Michael Jordan. He met with Commissioner David Stern and several other league officials, and following the meeting in New York, Mike and company laced him up and met the New York Knicks at the Garden.
You know, if I have any problems away from the basketball court, when I play basketball, and I'm out there playing, I got a solution for that. You know, so it's like my psychologist or whatever. And if you ever take that away from me, I wouldn't know what to do.
Michael Jordan at his best. There's very few people on this planet that can do this.
Simply the standard by which basketball excellence is measured.
The NBA regular season ended with everyone trying to catch up to the Bulls. Now, as Chicago gets ready to defend their title, I caught up with Michael Jordan to talk about it.
Throw it up here so you can tear a camera up.
You almost did.
I got great hands. You don't feel like I can throw it 65 yards, man?
I don't believe it.
We can mark it off.
Mark it off. You get down there.
You ready, George?
Easy.
Right there. That's with a sore wrist, man. You ought to see our football games.
I was running.
He
was running. Blocking.
George in the bushes like this with one leg. Talking about, I didn't think you were going to hit me that hard.
knocked me out. And then I thought they had Fred. Because Fred wouldn't block.
I pissed off Fred.
I don't know.
In a book I read about you, it said when you were a baseball player in Pee Wee League, it said that you threw 3 no-hitters.
I did. Where they found that out, I don't know. I think they asked my father that. He kind of lied. But that's okay. It's in the book. It's a record now.
I'm a people's person, even though that's getting a little stretched now, because I want my privacy a little bit more. But I try to be as normal as possible. The person that you see is me, I think.
What?
You
don't like it.
You gonna move?
Oh, I ain't gonna move for a long time.
Yeah, I know. When you move, I'll move next door.
Yeah, me too.
Chicago Stadium, the site tonight as the Bulls begin defense of their NBA championship.
This is the biggest focus of the season, is the playoffs.
And welcome to the excitement of NBA playoff basketball.
I thrive on it. I love it. It's a joy for me to step in front of that camera when you know millions of people are watching and show the skills and the creativity that you have as an athlete. Showtime. Kyle started getting going, man, and it's like you feel it go right through you.
Yes.
Jordan drives again.
Yep, Jay pushes it up himself. Crosses over, down the lane. Hangs, scores!
Well, young fella, I'm only going to hit a jumper. I'm not going to dunk on you. Michael, he smiled at Glenn Rice and told him, I'm just going to take you to school.
We knew we was going to win. It's just a matter of how we were going to win. So we kind of toured with them.
He wants it. Sees the double team coming and just goes to the hoop.
We were more talkative, more playful, more entertaining with them than any other team that we faced. But when it came down to where we had to put these guys away and move on, you know, we did it.
Edwards drives it against Jordan. Michael knocks it away and gets it right back. He's got Livingston in his right, Horace Grant in his left. Goes inside.
Oh, classic Jordan! Classic Michael Jordan time!
The Chicago Bulls have defeated the Miami Heat in 3 straight games.
Yeah, I was very nervous, which, you know, very rare do I get nervous in any circumstance. I knew I was against a person that was totally out of my league. It's been a lot of things written about him, and I just wanted to find out for myself.
He came to me about doing jam, and I told him it was a touchy time because it was the playoffs, and he said that basically he can work around my schedule.
Here we go, and roll please.
I'm gonna get this sooner or later. I'm gonna get it. You watch. For the day, I get it.
Here you're talking about a guy who I admired ever since he was a child up until this point. You can see that when he's in front of the camera and his music is playing, it's like, when I'm in front of the camera and I'm playing basketball, everything else is irrelevant.
Mike, why do you always fall for this?
Oh, I don't know. You look like you're gonna shoot.
I know. Big hands.
We just came off a very convincing series against Miami. We thought we could waltz right through New York.
Knicks lead it 4-0.
Yes, sir. Oakley just came over and annihilated Bill Cartwright.
And showing tenacious defense. 3.
B.J. Armstrong with the spot up that shot.
That's a violation. It'll be the Knicks ball.
We anticipated playing them a certain way, and they came out totally different. Physical, hungry, aggressive.
Chicago is a confident, cocky team. They've sort of breezed through the league all season. They breezed through the first round of the playoffs, and right now, they're being challenged.
Big J!
jammed by Ewing. They are stunned here at Chicago Stadium.
They shocked us the first game in our place, which was very embarrassing to us.
This team is for real. If anybody took them for granted, you know, certainly we realize that, you know, they're a team to deal with.
If New York has an advantage, it's the feeling that they can muscle Chicago inside.
McDaniel into Ewing for the jam.
This is a big, physical, wide New York team that plays you tough. It takes its toll on you.
Purdue with the bad pass. Wilkins follows. Jordan knocked it out of bounds. Chicago ball. What a great effort by Michael Jordan.
Comes out for Jordan off the screen. Makes the move. Comes back. Gets the lead. Well,
it's a steal by Jordan.
We seem to have control of the series. We never really did. And they kept coming and taking it back.
Shot clock to three. Ewing with the steal. It's a three-on-one. Jackson behind the three.
People think because the Bulls are the world champion, we're supposed to just lay down and just let them do whatever they want to us. Hey, this is a game. This is a man's game.
Ooh, hit hard by Anthony and Michael threw the ball at Anthony. Jordan is very upset.
It's more like Jordan with a recovery.
Oh, he is ripped by Sparks. This has become a war.
Here's Ewing.
Yes.
And the Knicks continue the incredible finish. They send it to a seventh and final game.
No, they're fighting like cats and dogs. And then we just fell apart.
You think you're going home for
this last game?
Do we have a choice?
Can you recover?
Yeah, we don't have a choice.
Some predicted a sweep, most a five-game series, but be honest now, nobody thought it would go seven.
If we see a New York victory today, this might well rank as one of the biggest upsets in the history of the NBA.
Now, the New York series was one of those fatherly advice type of series, so I kind of asked him, what should I do? How should I attack? Should I feed off my teammates, or should I go out and be the leader and let them follow my lead? And like most fathers, I mean, he said, take the lead. If they don't follow you, they don't follow you. But you have to take the lead.
Cartwright, they're fouled hard by Oakley again. It's a flagrant foul again.
And now, McDaniel wants a piece of Pippen.
I was ready to go blows with him.
Both clubs going at each other. Michael Jordan and Xavier McDaniel having words.
I felt that I had to talk trash to the bully so we all can gain confidence.
Pippen to Jordan. Reverse, and he hit it with the left hand. Oh, what a skip by Jordan. Jordan on fire. Here's Jordan splitting through. Jordan with the steal. And then it's stolen by Starks. McDaniel, two by Jordan. It's a clean block. Whose game is it? It's Michael Jordan's game.
That's just a part of the role that I have on the team, is to be able to lead. So that fatherly advice kind of worked in hand for me that day. I began weights about 2.5 years ago. I was absorbing a lot of physical beatings from Detroit, from New York. They felt this is the way to play Michael Jordan, is to physically beat him.
He's got a lot stronger, a lot stronger.
Jordan's the first person I met in Chicago. Bulls didn't pick me up at the airport, so he had a limousine service that was running, and his person didn't show up, his passenger didn't show up, and he charged me $30. So he took me right from the beginning. To take me where I had to go.
I gotta tell you something, though. First time I picked him up, he looked like a lost puppy dog at the airport. He scrunched down in the back of that limo and...
I gained weight. I got up to 213, 214, which is the heaviest I've ever been. And I'm a lot stronger at the end of the season.
Good deal.
We didn't used to work out on game days, but to keep the weight regular, we do it now. And it hasn't affected his shooting or his playing any. If it did, he would obviously let me know. And plus, it was his idea.
Puts me in an aggressive mood, I guess, so when game time comes, I don't let anyone take advantage of me.
Michael Jordan has just dismantled the Cleveland Cavaliers.
And the Chicago Bulls will make their second straight trip to the NBA Finals, where the Portland Trail Blazers await.
It was a tailor-made final.
This is a series everybody has been waiting for with bated breath for 2 years.
Portland was going to play against Chicago.
The world, the country wants to see Portland versus Chicago.
And then it became individual competition.
Jordan against Drexler, Clyde against Michael.
See, this is what Michael lived for. He wanted this challenge, showing Clyde, not only Clyde, but the world that, hey, I am the greatest, I am the best in the world.
This is the inner thought that I had. This is my motivation. And that's not to get Clyde mad at me if he ever sees this video, but when the game and when the ball's thrown up, it's going to be a differential between the two of us, and I'm going to let you choose which is this.
Michael sideline, he runs right by him. Stop, fires, come on!
Jordan Looney Robinson, yes! Jordan posting up, goes to the fadeaway, three to five!
I was in a groove, I was in a rhythm that I can't really explain.
Blazers get back, Pippen back for Jordan for three!
I started hitting threes like they were free throws. The rim seems like a big old huge bucket.
Back to Michael. Just to fire the three. And it's over. That's unbelievable.
And I can't miss it.
Come Michael. Three again. No. Three
is hot. Woo. The ball is stolen by Pippen. Two men to beat. Right for the basket. Stolen by Michael Jordan. Jordan with his magic carpet threw it down. He's everywhere. This place is pandemonium. Grant for the rebound.
After a while, I just looked at Marvin and Magic and those guys. What can I say? I mean, it's not me. It's just a moment.
This is the greatest performance maybe ever in the history of this league.
I'm a very competitive person. I mean, I hate to lose. I compete at practically everything, and competition is everything to me.
The Trailblazers win game four and tie this series at two games apiece.
When you lose, you're easily forgotten, and I don't think anyone want to go to their graves forgotten.
And the defending world champions are one victory away from making it two NBA titles in a row.
To compete, to win, it's all I live for, really.
Game six, a 3-2 Bulls lead in the series.
This is the 104th game of the year for the Bulls. That's a long haul, and it could all end here this afternoon. Rebound. Almost traveled to the backcourt. Cross-court pass stolen by Ford. Jordan. Double pump. Wheels. Missed the wide-open layup. Reached out to push, and Jordan drives to the basket. Double pump. Lays it up short. No good. Ball knocked out of bounds by Michael.
And Michael Jordan is tired. He's a tired player.
I was a little tired, and Phil knew I was a little tired, and he put me over, and he said, well, let's see what happens with this second team.
Tipping out front. Starts a move on Duckworth. Jump pass left side. BJ in the left corner. Hanson fires a three and scores.
Next thing you know, I'm on the sideline. I'm watching this. I'm like them, when I'm playing.
Now to Pippen, backs in on Drexler. Turns, double, triple team, spins through it and lays it in. The lead is down to five.
All I wanted was a second chance because, all up to that point, I was playing like the dog. And then I started looking at Phil like, okay, I'm ready now. This could be the time. Put me back in.
And Jordan re-enters the fray. It'll be Jordan against Drexler. Foot fake, starts to move, beats Clyde inside, looks up a corner and scores!
Oh, that was an unbelievable shot!
Out of Jordan. Jordan wants to go one-on-one on Drexler. Fake left, dribbles right, hang, shoots, scores! We're tied at 87! And Jordan knocked it away, and Jansen! And the ball takes the lead! Superman is back in the building! Superman is back in the building!
Second straight season.
No matter what people said about me during the course of the year, what negative things happened to me, it never affected us as a team. We kept focusing, kept moving towards that ultimate goal is to win a championship.
The Bulls have repeated.
Let the party begin.
We did it back to back, and this year we did it in Chicago, so we wanted to celebrate with Chicago.
And we're told they are bringing the championship trophy to the floor.
Chicago Stadium is going wild, as you can imagine.
I've never seen Michael like this up on the scorer's table.
I want to be like you.
We play golf every day. If Chuck Daly played me over 10 minutes, I'm quitting.
When the idea came out to elect professional players, I was a little against it.
My biggest concern was, as I've always said, is would I have the time to relax?
For some reason, it happened either way, and I found myself on that team.
With all these stars on the team, if it comes down to the last shot, who's going to take the shot?
Me.
I remember when I first got there, and Chuck Daly said, well, do you want to be team captain? We got Larry and we got Magic. Do you want to be the third team captain? I said, no.
I'm the young guy with the elder state.
This is their first Olympics. I've been there. They're a little bit older than I am.
He's a young puppy, and the rest of them are young puppies. I'm the big dog here.
And that's a heck of a responsibility to try to keep all these egos in one big bag.
You can't get too close to Michael. It's a foul.
You haven't committed a foul in almost a year and a half, man. How can you talk? My goodness. I don't think you ever fouled out of a game. When do you ever foul out of a game?
So I kind of stepped to the back and just rode along with for the ride.
Big smile. That's perfect. Ooh, la la.
Well, the all-time best was Monte Carlo.
We went to Monte Carlo for practice, but we had some time for relaxation as well. And for me, that means one thing.
Hold up, Doc. I got the coach. That means we get to go first.
Well, I went up with Chuck Daly and Rod Thorne and all those guys went up and played.
Are you a Chicago Bulls fan? Then you're not going to hit that straight.
It was beautiful up there.
Yep, hit a tree. Oh, exactly. Came back.
They didn't have carts. You had to walk up and down the hills, which, you know, sometimes was very difficult, but it was an escape.
Okay. Turn. Keep going. Get up the hill.
I played like a pig. Mike played pretty well.
I had to get too many strokes.
Well, I'm down 2-0 to Rod, even with Chuck. Down 2 to PJ, so I'm losing. They want strokes left and right, and now I'm dying over it. When you guys get the hell out of here, maybe we can play some golf. Don't that sound like Bobby Knight?
One of the reasons that I went to the Olympics was to see how everybody practiced, see if they took practice as serious as games. Every practice was really intense. One team will win first half of practice, which motivates the second team to come back and win the second half of practice.
Charles, how you like that ass kicking we gave you?
Oh, no. Come on now. I don't think y'all caught up with it. Oh, yeah, crazy.
Whole second half of practice.
Tell him.
The whole
tell him,
D.R. He maybe came down here once or twice.
Please.
There was a lot of trash talking. And with Magic running the point guard, he's trying to show everybody he's back, and his mouth starts running, and then everything starts to go. Barkley starts talking, Clyde starts talking, even Magic and myself, we started talking. I got 5 championship rings, this is what we used to do, and blah, blah, blah. And my rebuttal to that was, it's a new kid in town now. You retire, you want to come back, but if you come back, this is the treatment that you're going to get. No matter what happened in the games, nothing could equal what we were going through in Monte Carlo. And that was the best part.
It was a little bit more of a spectacle than I thought and dreamed of. Police escorts everywhere. Helicopters following us. Sometimes we come out going to a game, you got 2,000 people lining down towards the hotel on our way to a game. We were the highlight of the Olympics. The dream team, everybody wanted to see us. They wanted to see us drive by, walk by, whatever. They just wanted to see what's been talked about and promoted so long. So we wanted to get out there and prove to everyone that the team that they sent over there was going to go over and do the job and, you know, accomplish the feat. We're like 12 Clint Eastwoods. We're out there to do a job. Yeah, we shake hands and take pictures with you early, but when the ball goes up, you know, that's it. It wasn't the challenge of winning. It was just a matter of how many points we would win by and how much we would dominate. There's no tension, there's no pressure. I just get up and play golf and play basketball and have a good time. Get the chance to know some of these guys on this team.
Come on, man, what's your bowling ball here?
Hey, that was a good joke. Did you do that too?
I did.
That was pretty good. I'm good.
I remember one night we stayed up to about 3 or 4 o'clock. It was myself, Larry, and Magic. And we just started talking about past games, past times. And we do it for almost 4 or 5 hours, you know. And I really enjoyed it. And I saw more of the human side of both of them. And this is exactly one of the reasons that I wanted to be a part of the team, was to get to know these guys away from the game.
Sometimes I dream that he is me. I just want to be like Chuck. I mean, Mike.
Charles is probably one of my best friends in the league.
In the spot, Mom?
And a lot of people say why.
Hey, let's go, Charles. Okay, let's go, man. Let's go.
Okay.
A lot of people felt, well, he was an ugly American because he looked so physical and so dominant. In some ways, that's the way Americans are sometimes when we're going against other countries. We got so much pride, we want to dominate.
29 unanswered points. This group may well be the greatest team ever assembled in the history of team sports.
We position ourselves for the medals, and now it's a matter of just going out there and doing it.
It is what, 6:30, 6:15, 6:45, something like that.
I'm drinking coffee.
It's got to be a hurt. Can we go now?
What's all these lights? Is this it right here? There's a lot of pressure put on us. And every day we deal with pressure in our profession.
Where are you from?
Albuquerque,
New Mexico.
Big Banners. Big
Banners. A lot of expectations, you know, a lot of different encounters or whatever.
Last night I hit my wall. Did you? I couldn't make a basket.
What are you doing up so early?
It's been a long, long season. I mean, it was almost 11-month season for me. And mentally, I was drained. But, you know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime thing with the Dream Team, so it was something that was easily accepted by everybody.
Olympic Stadium. Imagine, all the greatest athletes ever.
And to go out there and walk through it, and I got to see the circumstances that they had to deal with and the pressures that probably they felt walking on that field.
What about Edwin Moses? 122 consecutive races. Bob Beamon jumping 29 feet.
I don't know if I could have participated in that atmosphere. With me, it's a team's thing. But from an individual standpoint, it's no team. It's just you against the best in the world. That's a heck of a pressure to deal with.
Not too many people get the opportunity to be in the Olympics. Just happy I was one of them. I know a lot of people love to have a gold medal. I think everybody's got something to cherish. I think this is something that my kids are gonna love one day.
I guess the big thing about it was I represented my country with pride.
And the United States now leads by 50.
From this time to we all are dead and gone. It would never be that type of a talent at one particular time on the basketball court. That 92 team of 11 professionals and one college player would never be duplicated again. I think that's what makes the Dream Team so special, because it's a once-in-a-lifetime situation. Whoever saw that team participate or play saw our history.
Let's see all those Jordan guys. Come on, boys.
I was ready to go home. My family is my stability. And all before I got married and had my family, the public and the media got 95% of my time. Now it's reversed. And they helped me through tough situations when, you know, I don't have too many people to talk to. I can always talk to my family.
For the next page. Right. Again, Catwoman whips cracks. Where's the cracks?
Cracks.
She reaches through.
Parents could be better role models than any athlete could ever be. See, when I was a kid, I never really had a hero. My closest hero was my father.
I'll go back.
I got it.
Where are we going?
New York. I think a lot of things have been made of myself being a role model. Everyone's given up, you know, their day and their evening to help raise money for the Michael Jordan Foundation, which is a foundation that tries to benefit less fortunate kids and youth around the world. I like to see kids smile and do things so that in some ways they can follow. But I think earlier in my career, I tried to live like everyone wanted me to live, the purest of all people. There's no such thing. And I think that was evident and that was shown through the course of this year. That's why I wouldn't change anything over the course of this year, because all of it's been a learning process for me. From the book to the gambling to all the different positive things that's happened to me over the course of 1 year, I wouldn't change, because I think it's made me a better person.
There's a couple things I want to say, though, about the ring ceremony. Of course, it's a celebration. It's a celebration of the ring. It's a celebration of last year's championship. But for us, it's a celebration of playing together.
It's the last time that you can celebrate what happened the previous year. It's the last little bit of joy and fun and excitement.
Good, Black man. How you feeling, man?
Good, good.
Take it easy.
Yeah, man.
You walk up and you get to the floor and the crowd shows you their respect. They pay you their respects for what you accomplished last year and what you're about to accomplish this year.
But once again, I want to say thanks. It's been 8 years going into my ninth year, and we got 2 championships, and hopefully we got a lot left.
You carry those memories with you forever, but now it's a sense of motivation that, okay, we got to get another one. You got to do this again. That's enough to keep coming back every November. Success is enough to keep coming back.
From North Carolina, Edgar 66, Michael Jordan.
Quiet, please.
We'll take 3.
Quiet, please, folks.
Quiet.
3, 2, 1.
Action.
I knew we should have taken that right turn in Albuquerque.
Never.
You just waste them.
I swear you just waste them.
Hey, look at the camera. Say hello. Say hello.
It's Marcus. Who's your favorite player?
BJ. I'm
getting some A's, man. Take him out. Hey, what's your growing up? Take him out.
How old do you think BJ is?
Fly.
Show him your big old hand. Get some big hand.
My wife is not, she's a cook, but she's not a cook. You know, she doesn't invent things. You know, she warms up things very well. She's gonna love that.
Don't daddy put a diaper on you every night.
Hang time is perception. That's all it is. 1, 2. This man is doing 60 pounds. It's like an oasis in the desert. You only see what you want to see.
We're taping a show over here. Could you be quiet over there for a little while?
Say bye-bye. Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Say bye when you need it.
Bye.